Welcome to the Control-M Workload Automation Planning Jobs module. Before starting this module, we recommend that you watch the Control-M Workload Automation Overview. In this module, you will learn about planning, defining, and updating job flows in Control-M. This is a typical way to define a job flow. First, you set up a workspace. Then you add new jobs to the workspace or edit jobs that were previously defined. Jobs are organized into folders. In previous software versions, folders were referred to as tables. Next, you define general parameters, such as the name and path of the script that you want the job to run, and when to run the job. When there are several jobs in the workspace, you can define dependencies between jobs. For example, you could determine that the execution of one job depends on the successful completion of another job. The last step is to save your work. This includes a few options that you will see later in this module. Next, you will use these steps to define a new job flow and edit an existing one. Let's learn how to define a new job flow. Consider the following scenario. Laura from the distribution department has just called. A new distribution center is about to be opened. Therefore, a new business flow is required, which will allow your company to send all the relevant shipment requests to the new distribution center. Your analysis shows that two jobs are required. The first one, named Retrieve Shipment, activates a script that will run at 4 p.m. during weekdays and retrieve the relevant shipment requests. The second job, named Copy Shipment, runs after the completion of the Retrieve Shipment job. The Copy Shipment job activates a command that copies the shipment requests to the new distribution center's network. Let's start by clicking the planning icon to open a new tab in the planning domain. The first step in defining a job flow is to set up a workspace. In order to create a new distribution center job flow, you need to create a blank workspace. You can use the blank workspace button at the top of the screen, or use the blank workspace icon on the right side of the screen. Click blank workspace. This is your workspace, the document in which you edit jobs. In the workspace tab, you will find the most common options that you will use. Now that you have created a workspace, you can start defining jobs. According to our scenario, you need to define two jobs, Retrieve Shipment and Copy Shipment. On the left side of the Workspace tab, you will find the New Jobs palette. It contains out-of-the-box job types that Control-M supports. In our scenario, the first job is an operating system job because it runs a script. So we will select the OS job type and drag it to the workspace. When dragging a job to an empty location in the workspace, a folder is created automatically. Your first job has been added to the workspace. All of the workspace's entities appear in the tree view as well, for easy tracking. In the workspace, as well as in the other domains of Control-M Workload Automation, when you click an object, you can see the object's properties on the right side of the screen. Let's change the name of the folder to Distribution Center 24. Now, let's return to the job. Click the job to select it. The general area contains basic information about the job. This information can vary depending on the job type. The job type is represented by the icon next to the job name in the top panel of the properties area. Notice that some of the fields are marked in red. These are mandatory fields. You must fill in these fields before saving the data in the job definitions database. Let's start by changing the job's name to Retrieve_Shipment. Next, We'll choose whether the job is a script, a command, or an embedded script. In our scenario, we want to run a script. Therefore, we'll define the path to the script and the script's file name. The runAs field identifies the username with the authorization to execute the job. You can see more properties by scrolling down and clicking More. Scheduling is how you indicate when jobs are eligible to be ordered and run. For example, every day, on specific days, or according to a predefined calendar. In our scenario, the job should be run on weekdays, starting at 4 p.m. Therefore, we will select Weekdays and then modify the time settings. In order to view the entire scheduling plan, you can click View Schedule. You can see that only weekdays are selected. Note that there are other job characteristics, such as prerequisites and automatic actions, that are not covered in this module. We have created the retrieve shipment job, and you've defined its general parameters and scheduling plan. Now let's define the second job. We'll create a second OS job type by dragging it from the job palette directly into the Distribution Center 24 folder. You can move the job by clicking and dragging the icon on the top right. Because the job's mission is to copy the shipment request, we'll choose Command. Next, let's define the scheduling parameters for this job. We'll select Every Day. Now that we have defined the two jobs, we will create a dependency between them. In our scenario, we want the copy shipment job to run after a successful run of the retrieve shipment job. Here's how it's done. You define dependencies by clicking the bottom part of the job that you want to run first, and then dragging the arrow to the next job. That's it! There are other methods for defining dependencies and other run conditions, but this is the most basic and useful method. Now that we have defined our jobs and their dependencies, you can either save your work or check it in. What is the difference between save and check in? Save saves the workspace as a document in a centralized location from which you can continue your work at another time. Saving a workspace does not require the workspace to be complete or fully operational. Check in merges the changes that were made in the workspace into the job definitions database, allowing the jobs to be ordered into the active jobs environment and submitted to run. Check-in requires the workspace and job definitions to be fully functional. In this scenario, Laura is yet to give her final approval. For the time being, you should save the workspace. After Laura's approval, we'll check in the workspace. To save, simply click the Save button. You need to enter a name for the workspace so that you or other people can access the workspace at a later time. Let's save the workspace as Distribution Center 24. The next time you are in the Planning Home tab, you will see the saved workspace under My Workspaces. You can always open a workspace that you saved and continue working on it. Laura has just called and approved the new flow. It can now be checked into the Job Definitions database. Open the workspace that we saved, click Distribution Center 24. Click Check In. The system performs the required operations, validates the jobs, and then merges the jobs into the job definitions database. Now that you've learned how to create a job flow, the next step is to learn how to update an existing job flow. A week has passed and Laura has called with a request. She wants to change the business flow, so a report is sent to the manager each morning about the shipments that were sent out the day before. This requires adding a new job to the job flow that will generate a report and send it to the manager. The job will be a database type job that creates the required SQL query. Instead of creating a new job, we can track down a similar job and copy it to our job flow. This will save time and prevent errors. Now we will work with two folders that already exist. First, from the Home tab of the Planning domain, let's choose Load Folders and Jobs to open the folders in a workspace. The first one is Distribution Center 24 that we created earlier, and the other is General Reports that contains the job that we want to copy. Now click Open. Loading the jobs and folders opens a new workspace. If you want to edit any of the jobs, you need to check them out. Checking out jobs and folders prevents other users from editing them. When you check out jobs, the original job definitions remain in the job definitions database and will run as scheduled according to their existing settings. To update our job flow, we will check out the jobs and folders that we loaded into the workspace. Click Check Out. You can locate the job that you want to copy by using the Find option. Click Find. The Find option is not case sensitive. After locating the job, you can either zoom in to see its details or zoom out to get a better view of your job environment. You can also control the workspace display by using the Network Overview option at the bottom of the screen. If we look at the job's properties, we see that the Shipment Report job is a database job type. Let's copy the job by right-clicking it and selecting Copy. Next, we will select the Distribution Center 24 folder using the Tree View. And click Paste to add the job to the folder. Note that Paste creates a new copy of the job. You can edit the new job's properties without affecting the original ones. In our scenario, we need to modify the job name to shipment_report. The next step is to define the job's dependencies. It has to run after the retrieve shipment job. We will define the dependency by dragging the arrow between the two jobs. For a more organized display, you can use the rearrange option. Last, we will check in the modified workspace so that the new job will be added to the job flow in the job definitions database. Click Check In. After checking in a workspace, if you want to test a job flow without waiting for its scheduled time, you can order a workspace. Ordering places the job flow in the active jobs environment so that the jobs will be submitted. Let's summarize what you have learned in this module. You have learned that to start working, you need a workspace, and that there are several options for setting up a workspace. When defining a new job flow, you open a new blank workspace. You can also open a workspace that was previously saved. Last, you can load jobs from the job definitions database into a workspace. Remember, if you want to modify jobs, you need to first check out the workspace. The next step was to define jobs and their properties. You have learned how to create dependencies between jobs by connecting one job to the other. Finally, you have learned how to save or check in your work and the difference between saving and checking in. In this module, we covered basic common functions. We hope it gave you a starting point for exploring additional features and functionalities of the planning domain. You have just completed the Planning Jobs module. It is recommended that you now watch the Monitoring Jobs module. Thank you for viewing this module.